Welcome back to Cooking with Kim Kim. Today we're gonna be making Leon's favorite stew. Just started raining here in Washington, so figured this would be nice comfort food for today. What we have is 4.5 cups beef stock. We have 1/4 cup of water, 1/4 cup of cornstarch, 10 garlic cloves minced, 1.5 tablespoons of salt, 3 teaspoons of pepper, 2 tablespoons olive oil, and what we have here is an herb blend. There's rosemary, thyme, oregano, basil, and sage, and I just blended them up to make kind of a fine powder. And there's 3 tablespoons of that. We have 1.5 tablespoons of Worcestershire, however it's pronounced. 2 cups of red wine. And then this was just over 4 pounds of chuck roast. I got that at Costco. They have really beautiful prime chuck roast for pretty inexpensive. And then 2 medium white onions. Just sliced. 3 cups of baby carrots. I have 3 gold potatoes and 3 red potatoes that are just 1/4 or 1/6, depending on the size. You just kind of want to keep them uniform so they'll cook all at the same time. And then about 3/4 of a pound of green beans that I have cleaned and trimmed. Reminds me of being a kid sitting at the kitchen table and my mom making me clean and trim the green beans. Wasn't my favorite chore to do. Okay, now that we have everything set up and ready to go, I have my meat, sprinkle the pepper and salt, and stir that just so everything's evenly coated. Get my burner going here. Medium high heat. We're gonna sear this meat just to add an extra depth of flavor in the stew. Add about 2 tablespoons olive oil to the pan. And I have the rest of my ingredients that I'm gonna add into this pan after we're done searing. Now I'm gonna be cooking everything in the Dutch oven, but if you don't have a Dutch oven, you can just sear it in a pan. You'll cook the onions in the same pan and then just throw everything in the crock pot. Cook it on low for probably 8 to 10 hours or high for 4 to 6 hours. Okay, our oil is up to temp. So I'm just gonna take a few of these and put them in here and get them started to brown. Key here is to not overcrowd them, or you'll steam the meat rather than having a good sear on it for the extra flavor. So this will be need to be done in a few batches. Same thing on the other side. Doesn't matter that it's not cooked through. Go ahead and take these out and set them aside. You're gonna get some nice browning in the pan. That's all good flavor. Okay, now that all our meat is done, that's not burned, that's flavor. We want to keep all of that. Little extra olive oil in here to cook the onions. Okay. Notice I'm scraping up all of those bits on the bottom of the pan to get with the onions. Pinch of salt. Pinch of pepper. And cook this for about 3 minutes. We're going to add our garlic. Cook this about 30 seconds. Add our herb blend. And our Worcestershire, whatever. All right, now the sauce all blended together, I'm going to deglaze with the wine. That's going to pick up all that good flavor that was on the bottom of the pan and incorporate it in here just for another depth of flavor. Add my beef stock. Once this all marries together, I'm going to add the beef back into it, and then I'm going to cover it and cook it for about 3 hours. Then I'm going to add the potatoes and the carrots, and then within the last probably 30 minutes of cooking, I will add the green beans. You don't want to add them too soon because they'll just get mushy. You'll want to bring this back up to a boil after you've added all the meat and the juices back inside of here. When it gets to a boil, reduce your heat to low and cover and cook for 3 hours. While your beef is cooking, if you've already cut your potatoes like I did for prep, you can just put them in water and they won't discolor. We're at the 3 hour mark. I turned it back up to high to get it boiling. I'm gonna add the carrots and drain the potatoes and add those as well. Bring it back up to a boil. And we'll put the lid back on it and simmer again for probably 2.5 more hours. Then add the green beans, cook for 30 minutes, it'll be done. When the potatoes are fork tender, add the green beans. And cook another 30 minutes. So now that the meat and the vegetables are all cooked, I'm gonna just take them out of the pot, put them in a bowl here, and I'm gonna reserve the juice so I can make the slurry, make it more like a gravy. I'm gonna turn the heat back up to high to bring it back to a boil. Have a quarter cup of water, quarter cup of cornstarch. This is gonna make my slurry. Just mix these together until it's fully combined. As it comes back to a boil, mix in the slurry. That'll thicken up the sauce. Season with salt and pepper. I'm gonna put this back in the bowl. Carefully.
that you try not to splash it too much. There we go. A hearty beef stew with a cheddar corn biscuit.